Good morning and welcome. We'll rise on this first Friday of Lent, beginning with the Lord who through all these holy days.
Lord who through all these holy days, for us to fast and pray, teach us to do good in our sins and close by you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
We gather on this first Friday in Lent. We hear about fasting in our scriptures. So let us open our hearts, recognize that call in our life to really fast and turn our attention to our Lord as we seek his mercy and forgiveness for our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Show gracious favor, O Lord, we pray, to the works of penance we have begun, that we may have strength to accomplish with sincerity the bodily observances we undertake. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord God, cry out full-throated and unsparingly. Lift up your voice like a trumpet blast. Tell my people their wickedness and the house of Jacob their sins. They seek me day after day and desire to know my ways, like a nation that has done what is just and not abandoned the law of the Lord. They ask me to declare what is due them, pleased to gain access to God. Why do you fast and you do not? Why do we fast and you do not see it? Afflict ourselves and you take no note of it. Lo, on your fast day you carry out your own pursuits and drive all your laborers. Yes, your fast ends in quarreling and fighting, striking with wicked claw. Would that today you might fast so as to make your voice heard on high. Is this the manner of fasting I wish, of keeping a day of penance, that a man bow his head like a reed and lie in sackcloth and ashes? Do you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? This, rather, is the fast that I wish, releasing those bound unjustly, untying the thongs of the yoke, setting free the oppressed, breaking every yoke, sharing your bread with the hungry, sheltering the oppressed and the homeless, clothing the naked when you see them, and not turning your back on your own. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go before you, and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, here I am. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
A heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn.
A heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn.
John approached Jesus and said, "Why do we and the Pharisees fast much, but your disciples do not fast?" Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? The days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and then they will fast." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So our Lenten challenge is to be about 1% of the time of our day, 14 minutes and 24 seconds, to open our Bible and to pray. And on the flip side of the card is a listing of the Gospels, the Lenten Gospels, and pray this. So I'm really going to encourage you to be serious about that and do that. We're not going to take roll call on who did it today, because maybe you're going to do it later today. But I want to encourage us and role model the sense of doing that. First of all, when you step back and you go through wonderful scriptures today, the first reading from Isaiah, great information about fasting and why they do it and explaining it in the Old Testament. Very short gospel with, you know, connection and fasting, and our Lent, our gospels, our readings will typically connect because they're chosen to do that. But there's so much there. What is the message for you? What is the message for me in each of these? And that's why I'm really encouraging this 1% of prayer, so that we really open ourselves not to a huge Bible study and getting every detail down, but to a message that's personal for each of us. What is God telling us today? So we'll just work with the gospel just a little bit this morning again, because that's what's on the card. And then in the front of the card also has those steps in doing that. So it asks us first to prepare, and part of that preparation is the sign of the cross. And we did that at the beginning of Mass, putting ourselves into God's presence. And then also taking that moment to quiet ourselves down and still ourselves. Hopefully for most of us that happened before Mass started. And then inviting the Holy Spirit into the prayer time. So let's just take a moment now. And then in our hearts, when we're doing this home or wherever we choose to go to pray, just inviting the Holy Spirit in a simple prayer to be in our hearts, to set aside all the distractions of the moment and all the other demands, but just to be present and inviting the Holy Spirit. And then having done that, the next step is to read. Because we've read it once, and I'm going to read it again for you. Just invite you to listen and let the image, let the passage flow through you on the first or second read through. And kind of getting the lay of the land and getting the full sense of what's going on, looking for where we might just drop and connect. The disciples of John approached Jesus and said, "Why do we and the Pharisees fast much, but your disciples do not?" Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? The days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and they will fast. Then they will fast." You know, I was encouraged to read it two or three times to kind of get that sense, and like the third time through, just stop whatever is connecting with you. And then that moves you to the next step of your flight. So I'll read it again. This time just kind of catch whatever speaks to you at this moment. The disciples of John approached Jesus and said, "Why do we and the Pharisees fast much, but your disciples do not fast?" Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? The days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and then they will fast." phrase, what image, what thought caught you? This is the reflect moment. What is the meaning of whatever caught your attention? Possibly imagine yourself as part of the scene and experiencing that and just holding on to that message. And then as we reflect with that, what is the Lord saying through the text to you? Then to role model, to share this as an example for me this morning as I prayed over this, it's that line of Jesus answered them, can the wedding guests mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? Jesus answered them. And looking for me as I reflected and prepared to respond to that, the reflection was, is that, you know, Jesus was asked a question about why don't your disciples fast? And he's answering the question with a question. And in fact, his answer, his question answered that really doesn't answer the first question. For me, it put the focus on him. And then that's the part about, can the wedding guests mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? Jesus Christ is my bridegroom. We're at the wedding guests with them. Where is my attention? On the rules of fasting or on the groom of Jesus Christ himself? So they call him back to reflect closer just on Christ. And the response, the next step, the response is you talk to God about the passage and anything else in your heart and blessings received. Kind of the changes actions that are drawing all of this from me. And for me, I have a very busy day, and it can be all about the work, or it can be all about Jesus Christ. And so my response is, challenge myself to focus that it's about the groom at the wedding feast, as I do a funeral today, as I do other things today, and not about all the details around it, but about Jesus Christ. And then the final step in that is just to rest in that message for a moment. So I'm going to invite you, hopefully I have a role model that for you. Hopefully you've caught something. You kind of reflected and said, this is perhaps what the Lord is saying to me. This is how I will respond today. And then we'll spend a moment just to rest with the Lord with that.
Rise and bring the prayer of whatever we've just received and these prayers to our God.
That the disciples of Jesus may reveal to the world the fast that God desires, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That civil leaders may attend to the needs of the poorest of their people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That families broken by anger or misunderstanding may not hide themselves from one another, but be reconciled. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lenten fast may shatter the yokes of poverty, hunger, and homelessness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the care of God's people may bring hope and comfort to the sick. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in this time of fasting, we may shine more brightly as beacons of God's glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead, especially Bob the Dead, may hear God's voice calling them on high. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. There may be an end to this pandemic, a rolling out of the vaccine for all people, and a movement from the fear of COVID to the safety from it. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for each other, opening our minds and hearts to the message of God and living it in our lives in these Lenten days. And we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray in prayer of St. Joseph, asking for his intercession. Good St. Joseph, as you led the Holy Family,
watch over our families, help our family and all families to know and share God's love.
In our family relationships, may we find healing and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of Jesus, who share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. And in a special way, bless our Holy Father, our bishops, and our priests. May they follow your humble example. fatherly care for the people of God, the Church. With Mary, you raised Jesus, the High Priest. You know our need for priests. Please raise up good and holy priests from our families to serve the people of our diocese. May our children and grandchildren hear and say yes to the call of Jesus, just as you and Mary did. Good Saint Joseph, pray for us. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we receive this bread. We offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it to become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we receive this wine. We offer you, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it to become for us our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the Church.
Show gracious favor, O Lord, we pray, to the works of penance we have begun, so that we may have strength to accomplish with sincerity the bodily observances we undertake. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal, through Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gift each year, your faithful await the sacred paschal feasts with the joy of minds made pure, so that more eagerly intent on prayer and on the works of charity and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the fullness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory. It's without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." And in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of our sins. Do this in memory of
the mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, David our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Francis of Assisi, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church." Graciously grant you peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not in the which you shall be shed.
Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Please pray with us now, the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Pray, Almighty God, that through partaking of this mystery, we may be cleansed of all our misdeeds, and so be suited for the remedies of your compassion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The purple cards for the 1% of your time for prayer, available at the doors in the back. I invite you on the way out if you want to share your prayer thought with me. I'm certainly open to hearing that on what struck you from the scriptures. The Lord be with you.
Thanks be to your spirit.
Bow down and pray for God's blessing. For your mighty deeds, O God of mercy, may your people offer endless thanks. And by observing the age-old disciplines along their pilgrim journey, may they merit to come and behold you forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father. And